please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Day of a new financial year, and it saw markets surging more than 1% in today's trade. So, for instance, the Nifty extended its gains in the last hour to end above that 200-day moving average. Sensex rallied 286 points. Mid-caps outperformed the benchmark indices with gains of almost about 2%. Banks, though, underperformed, led by Axis Bank and ICICI Bank. We'll tell you why in just a bit. But look at that bank index that closed with gains of just about 0.3%. Let's bring in Surabhi Upadhyay to give us a wrap of today's trading action. Hi, Surabhi. Bulls clearly dominating day one of the new financial year. But how steady is their footing versus the bears right now?
Solid start to the new financial year, FY19. It was bulls in control. Yes, you could argue that trading volumes were on the thinner side. It was a bank holiday here, and several Asian markets, as well as most of Europe, were still shut for the Easter holiday. But let's go with the figures that we finally have on the board. And that's a smart 1% rally on the Nifty and the Sensex, and even bigger gains for the mid-cap index. That index actually ending up almost 2%. Let's start with the large caps. I mean, there was all-round buying really coming through today. For instance, a lot of the pharma names found takers, whether it was Lupin or Cipla, even the likes of Sun Pharma, these stocks were up between 2 and 4%, depending on which one you were looking at. The sector of the day, really, however, for me, was autos. We've got some very strong sales numbers coming in from almost all of the companies, and that was showing up in stock prices once again. So Hero Motor, which declared numbers in the afternoon, blew past expectations. The stock rallied almost 3%. We had smart gains coming in on the likes of even a Tata Motors, where the CV sales continue to look very, very robust. And of course, even the likes of Bajaj Auto, despite some of the hiccups in the month gone by, were on the positive side. The bigger price action on autos actually happened beyond the index. That's where you saw a 7% move on an Escorts, about a 6% move on a TVS Motors. And let's not forget auto ancillaries. A lot of the related plays, whether it was tires or component manufacturers like Bharat Forge, these were stocks on the upswing today. I'll now come to banks, and this was the problem area for the market. There was marked underperformance by the Nifty Bank, and that was primarily because of two key stocks. The one big one, of course, being ICICI Bank, was down almost 6%, even towards the close, was down right from the word go today, and State Bank of India. The counterweight came in nicely in the form of an HDFC Bank. That one had consistent buying and gains of around 2.5% at close. But largely speaking, banks still a bit of a muddled lot. I'll now come to the outperformance in the mid-cap universe, because here is where there was a lot of pop, a lot of stocks moving around. Some examples, Hexaware, the mid-cap IT action continued, 10% up on that stock, big, big moves coming through. Dilip Buildcon, of course, road contractors have received a whole host of orders in the last few weeks of the previous fiscal, and some positive brokerage commentary helped this one notch up an 11% gain today. We had some of the NBFCs like DHFL, NMT Housing Finance. They were also looking smart towards the afternoon session. On the mid-cap side, let's not forget a clutch of the Tata Group stocks. Very interesting action today on Tata Coffee and Tata Global, between 6 and 7%. And even Voltas, some of the AC plays are pretty hot in the market now with the summers getting to scorching level. Finally, if there was one pocket of the market that didn't go down very well, it was, of course, the OMC universe. With oil prices being where they are, IOC, BPCL and HPCL, these became a bit of a no-go area.
Okay, fair enough, Surabhi. Thanks for joining in with that. Good day for the day one of the working financial year. But let's get you an exclusive from the electric vehicle space. Sources tell us that the government has cancelled nearly 50% e-bus tenders under the FAME policy. Ranjit Banerjee is here with the latest. Ron, why has this happened?
Well, it's a bit of a curious move, to say the least, Kritika, because just a week, 10 days ago, we had reported how the government had identified 11 cities and where, you know, Tata Motors, you know, one of the companies, had won the largest order. So in total, the size of this, of the electric bus tender was about 390. Tata Motors alone had won about 190. Chinese BYD had won additional 100-150. But now what we understand is that that tender has at least 50% of that order, or around 200 electric buses. For that, the tenders will have to be reissued. The cities that have been impacted because of this are 5 out of the 11 cities that were shortlisted. So cities like Bangalore, Mumbai, and Hyderabad are among the 3 cities that are impacted. There are 2 more cities like Jaipur and Indore, which are also impacted by this order. Now, what we understand at this point is that the government has said that subsidy under the FAME policy will be given only under a capex-led model or a capital expenditure-led model, unlike an opex model or an operational expense-led model, which was the case in many of these six cities. It is unclear at this point. It's hard to understand why has this decision been taken. We are hoping that the government will give us some clarification, maybe in a day or two. But this is a bit of a setback because this tendering process will have to be redone again for 5 out of the 11 cities. Tata Motors has been impacted in only one of the cities. So in one of the cities where they had won the bid, the bids will have to be opened afresh again. But Chinese BYD, which was the other big sort of winner in this tendering process, they, I am told, are the most impacted. But I'm still awaiting official responses from the companies.
Okay, fair enough, Ron. Thanks for joining in with that. Of course, we need some clarity on why and some more details. But as Ron was pointing out, that is a definite setback at this point in time. From one exclusive to another, after Ghee and Prasad from Temple's food and safety regulator, FSSAI, has now turned its eyes to sale of loose edible oil. Sources tell CNBC TV18 that FSSAI has asked Maharashtra and MPFDA to conduct sampling of loose edible oil and check on possible impurities. Before we get to that story, let's cut across to the Revenue Secretary, Hasmukh Adia, who is addressing a press conference on the e-way bills and the way forward.
कि इसके बारे में कुछ क्लैरिटी हो तो सबको ठीक रहता है और अगर हम प्रेस ब्रीफिंग के माध्यम से आपको नहीं बताएंगे फिर भी आप ढूंढ ही लेंगे इसलिए बेहतर यही है कि हम आपको जो भी आंकड़े हमारे पास है वो बता ही दें एक तो जो हम लोग जीएसटी के फिगर हर महीने का आपको देते हैं वो 25 तारीख तक का देते हैं बट जब महीना पूरा होते होते उसमें काफ़ी मतलब फ़र्क आ जाता है 3-4 हज़ार करोड़ तो और आ जाता है तो हमने ये ट्रेंड पिछले कई महीनों से देखा है तो आज एक प्रेस नोट नंबर 1 हम जो दे रहे हैं उसमें आपको हम दे रहे हैं कि पूरे के पूरे आंकड़े मंथ वाइज जो अगस्त से लेके अभी तक के मार्च तक के सब दे रहे हैं तो उसके हिसाब से अगर आप देखेंगे तो ट्रेंड इज़ अप स्विंग जैसे हमने 93,000 करोड़ से शुरू किया था 93,590 करोड़ जो सबसे पहले मंथ में था दूसरे मंथ में भी लगभग 93,000 करोड़ था फिर 95,000 करोड़ हो गया फिर सडनली नवंबर में 85,000 करोड़ हो गया जब भी हमने कुछ कंप्लायंस रिक्वायरमेंट को रिलैक्स करने का अनाउंस किया तो तुरंत गैप आ गया और फिर 83 हो गया फिर 88 हुआ और इस महीने मार्च में हमने जो इंटरिम फिगर दिया था आपको 86 या ऐसा कुछ था अभी तक ऑलरेडी 89,264 हो गया है So we are close to 90 now, end of March. And this is in spite of the fact that February was a month of 28 days. Phir bhi March ka collection isliye acha hai ki compliance bhi bada hai. Kuch hamare state aur central government ka officers logo ko unke piche bhi pade hue. Aur dusra ki March mein log apna clear karna chahte hai purani liability bhi. Isliye bhi thoda adhik usme aaya hai. 28 din ka mahina hone ke bawajood February se hamara adhik hua hai. 89,264 ये करके सो कुल मिला के सॉरी या दैट इज इन मार्च या दैट इज द फाइनल फिगर एंड ऑफ द मंथ सॉरी फेब्रुआरी कलेक्टेड इन मार्च और फेब्रुआरी कलेक्टेड इन फेब्रुआरी ऑल्सो जो IGST ऑन इम्पोर्ट का फिगर होता है फेब्रुआरी में ही आ जाता है ठीक है तो एक तो वो इन्फॉर्मेशन हम आपको प्रेस नोट नंबर 1 के जरिए दे रहे हैं सेकंड प्रेस नोट जो हम आपको दे रहे हैं वो इट इज़ अबाउट दी IGST रिफंड एंड दी एक्सपोर्ट रिफंड एंड अदर रिफंड एप्लीकेशंस विच आर पेंडिंग तो उसके लिए अभी तक जो काफ़ी सारी ऐसी बाज़ार में फिगर घूम रही थी और काफ़ी बदनामी भी GST की इस मामले में की गई है कि भाई 60,000 करोड़ का रिफंड पेंडिंग है एक्चुअली स्पीकिंग टिल डेट हमारे पास जो रिफंड एप्लीकेशन आई है वो सिर्फ 24,000 करोड़ की है 24,824 करोड़ की जो IGST रिफंड एज वेल एज अदर रिफंड जो RFD रिफंड का एप्लीकेशन जो स्टेट और सेंटर को जाता है इवन दूसरे मसले को लेकर न सिर्फ एक्सपोर्ट बट इवन कैश रिफंड की एप्लीकेशन सब मिला के ही उतना 25,000 करोड़ का था और उसमें काफ़ी कैंपेन करके जो CBEC की तरफ से और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से अभी तक काफ़ी सफलता मिली है पूरी फोर्टनाइट हमने सेलिब्रेट किया और उसमें से आज तक ऑलरेडी 17,616 करोड़ ऑफ रिफंड हैज़ बीन गिवन 616 करोड़ ऑफ रिफंड हैज़ ऑलरेडी बीन गिवन एंड देर आर सम मोर डिटेल्स अबाउट दिस IGST रिफंड विच आई विल सब्सिक्वेंटली request Chairman EC to view about the refund, because there are two types of refund, and in addition there is a duty drawback, in addition there is ROSL. So we are not including ROSL and duty drawback in this. This is purely IGST refund and refund out of refund application which is made to state or the central government. So dono ne milke ye kiya hai. IGST refund jo hai wo sirf central government wapis deti hai. तीसरी जो बात आज हम आपके सामने रखने जा रहे हैं वो है कि ई वे बिल का अभी तक दो दिन हो गया है. सिस्टम हैज़ बिन रोल्ड आउट, इट्स बिन वेरी सक्सेसफुल रोल आउट सो फार, देर इज़ नो ग्लिच एट ऑल फाउंड. एंड सो आई मस्ट कॉम्प्लीमेंट आवर टीम ऑफ टेक्निकल ऑफिसर्स हु हैव, ऑल्दो दे टुक टू मंथ्स टू मेक इट परफेक्ट, बट नाउ एटलीस्ट द ई वे बिल इज़ ऑन इट्स वे, एंड एट दिस रेट वी होप दैट वी विल बी एबल टू वेरी सून एज पर द डिक्लेयर टाइम टेबल आफ्टर ए वीक. We will also announce the states where it will come into being for intrastate also. Abhi to interstate ke liye compulsory hua hai. To aaj se, kal se jo shuru ho gaya, fortunately it was a Sunday, but still quite a few e-way bills were filed. And today also the pickup is there in the e-way bill, and nobody has found any difficulty so far. There are technical teams which are working on this, and I'll request GST and chairman subsequently to talk a little more about it, and also other GST and issues if there are any. Then we come to the next issue, the fourth issue. In fact, pardon us if your next press note says press note number 5, because there is one missing, but there is no press note number 4. So press note number 5 should be taken as press note number 4. That is about the collection figure of direct taxes, which we'll be giving. And we have exceeded our target of B for direct taxes, and we will talk more about it. I'll request my colleague Sushil Chandra to give more details about the direct tax collection. On the whole, let me tell you that this year has been very good, in spite of the fact that it was a year of uncertainty for revenue because of GST's introduction. But still, both in direct and indirect tax revenue, we have broadly met our target, and we are very much on course to achieve our fiscal deficit target. There is absolutely we are absolutely confident that we are meeting the fiscal deficit target of this year, and based on whatever figures we have got, even the tax figures which Mr. Sushil Chandra is going to announce today will go up, because it goes up, you know. People keep on paying taxes up to 31st night, and some of them do not come in the adjustment, because by then RTGS is closed or NEFT is closed. So some of those entries will come only tomorrow, because today the bank is closed. So there is no RTGS, NEFT adjustment being done. So next 3-4 days, we'll keep on getting some more addition to the revenue which we have already got so far up to 31st night. So we'll keep getting more of it. So I will are very much on course to achieve our fiscal deficit target. 6 is our target, na? 3.5. Okay. We'll be meeting our target. I'll request Chairman CBC to talk about the IGST and other refund. Sorry? We are meeting. This is because we have got the figures now. We are more confident because we have got the figures for 31st March. So we are meeting. Okay? Right. Okay. IGST and other refunds.
I just want to expand on the IGST to give you the total figure. The total refunds, as Finance Secretary has said, that we have given is 17,616. In this, I'll just give you very quickly the breakup. As far as IGST refunds is concerned, the total amount that has been sanctioned is 9,604. Just to give you an idea of how this has actually happened, as on 15th or 14th March, we had given out 5,339 crores. We put in the special drive because there were issues related to various problems that themselves had problems even in filling forms, etc. So in this special drive period, we have been able to give out 4,265 crores, taking this total to 9,604. Similarly, on the ITC refund side, what was sanctioned up to around the 14th of March was 4,374. During the special drive, about 1,136 crores was given out, and that took the total to 5,510. So overall, as you can see, both these together have given us a pretty good refund, and I think exporters now, in fact, have the FIO have even appreciated us today. There's a big ad in the paper thanking us, because I think now their major problems are sorted out. In addition to this, we've also given drawback, which I'll give you the figure for. An amount of 16,680 crores duty drawback has been disbursed for the period 1-7-2017 to 31st March 2018. 1,833 crores has been given as far as ROSL is concerned, again for the financial year 17-18. So this entire picture totals 17,600 and 16 crores. This is just the refunds, and then of course ROSL and drawback separately. So the whole thing comes to about 33 or 34,000 crores.
How much?
33 or 34,000 roughly. I've not done a calculation, but it works out to somewhere around that.
So all given?
All. That is ROSL, drawback, as well as ITC and IGST refund.
Okay, I'll request Chairman GST and Mr. Ajay Bhushan Pandey to talk about the e-way bill data as well as any other thing about GSTN.
The e-way bill was introduced since yesterday, and so far the performance, we are satisfied with the performance of the system. The yesterday total number of e-way bills that were generated was 2.59 lakhs. That was the first day. Now today, till now, 2.89 lakhs. We took the figure at around 3 o'clock, right, 4 o'clock. 2.89 lakhs e-way bills have been generated. Now our hourly rate, when we checked up last time today, is somewhere around 60,000 e-way bills per hour, and which we expect now that now, because now most of the e-way bills get prepared only in the early evening, so we expect that, you know, that this number will further go on. Right? We are also prepared for a much higher capacity, because yes, we took some time to you know, stabilize our system, did a very, very extensive load testing, and both how many e-way bills can be generated in a day, number one, and how many e-way bills can be generated within the time window of 10 minutes. Because, you know, we should be not only cater to an average load, but also the peak load. So this time, you know, we have done all this testing, and with that, we hope that so far as this e-way bill is concerned, it will roll out smoothly. On the other hand, we also have lined up, you know, as many as 100 agents who are available on call. If people from any part of the country, if they have any difficulty, they can call up, because it's a new system. So even if, let's say, the system has no problem, but still the taxpayer, you know, may have some, you know, confusion. So for helping such taxpayers, we have 100 agents who are working online, who are helping them, and so that they can learn the system of e-way bill. Now, till yesterday, around 11 lakh, more than 11 lakh dealers have registered for this e-way bill system. As many as 20 lakh transporters,
20,000
transporters also have now registered. So these are the numbers, and we hope that so far as the interstate is concerned, it will go very smoothly. Again, our finance secretary has mentioned that, you know, we will watch for about 7 days, and then thereafter we will roll out intra-state for the first batch of the states, and this is the way we will do this phase implementation. So I think we are on the track so far as the e-way bill is concerned. Now coming to the GSTN side, so I would like to tell you the overall total picture. The total, as you are aware, that from 1st of July this GST system came into place. Since then, we have processed, and you know, the people have kind of number of returns that have been filed is about 8.39 crores. The total number of dealers, the taxpayers who were migrated from the earlier system, and what was the earlier system? 35 states and union territories. Then CBEC and Central Excise and the Service Tax. So 37 systems got merged into one, and then each state had its own system, right? Even though it was a VAT, but still they had their own system. Now all those were migrated, and 64 lakh dealers got migrated into the new system. Now the new dealers, who got registered with the GSTN system is 36 lakhs. So total of roughly around 1 crore, 9 lakh, 10 lakhs, the dealers are there today on the GSTN system. They have filed 8.39 crore returns, which include the GSTR3B, GSTR1, GSTR2, you know, and many other, you know, the forms, total 8.39 crores. The if you talk about the 3B, because we get the major revenue through the 3B, 5.29 crore returns have been filed, you know, 3B returns, and we have got more than 5.40 crores of rupees through this GSTN system.
Lakh crores.
Sorry, 5.4 lakh, lakh crores in the GSTN system. Total number of challans that we processed in during the last 9 months is about 2.95 crore challans have been done. So this is how this, so the system as a technology wise, we can now fairly say that the system has stabilized. And this is the stabilized because, you know, these are the numbers that, one more very, very important figure which I would like to share with you is that total number of invoices which have been processed, because, you know, GSTR1, you know, we get the details of the invoice. The total number of invoices that we have processed is 239 crores invoices have been processed. So we can, we can say that, you know, this system has achieved certain stability, and it will continue to do so in the coming months also.
Okay. Thank you. I'll request.
No. I said that yesterday it was 2.59, right? Today till, you know, 4 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 2.89.
And at today,
No. Today.
Up to 3 o'clock.
Up to 3 o'clock. Fresh.
Up to 3 o'clock.
Right.
Okay, we'll take the questions later on, whichever subject you want to take. I'll request Chandra to talk about the income tax collections.
As on today, the provisional collection is 9.95 lakh crore against the BE of 9.8 lakh crore. That is, this is 17.1% higher than the net collections of last year. And it is 101.5% of the B. So we have already crossed the B, and we are in the process of getting the RE. And because these are the provisional figures as on today, and more collections likely to come. I would also like to say that the growth rate of net collections for the corporate income tax is 17.1%, and for personal income tax, it is 18.9%. The growth rate of net collections for income tax, for corporate tax, is 17.1%, and for personal income tax is 18.9%. One more important area is the number of returns which the income tax department has received during this year. As you are all aware, that there is an emphasis by the government to increase the tax net of this country. And I am happy to tell you that in this year, we have got 6.84 crore income tax returns as against last year of 5.43 crore income tax returns, 43, giving an increase of 26%. And in 6.84 crore returns, 6.74 crore returns are e-file. That shows that the persons are opting for e-file. We have opened offices for all 3 days. 56 lakhs returns were received. Yeah, in 2 days, last 2 days, 30th and 31st. And this was because of the continuous follow-up by our department, that we have issued large number of SMS, emails on the basis of data with us, because of which a lot of new returns had come, and something around 13,000 crore of self-assessment tax was also in last 2 months had come because of the continuous emphasis and continuous follow-up by the department on SMS, non-intrusive manner. We have intimated to the SSEs about their assets, about their properties, about the information with them. That is why they have filed returns. And if you compare it with 13-14, and that era, we were getting only 3.79 crore returns. And now from 13-14 to this date, we have reached to 6.84 crore returns, which is 80.5% higher. And if you just compare 13-14, and that year we got only 3.79 crore returns. And today we have got 6.84 crore returns. That is an increase of 80.5% as far as the returns are concerned.
Over
13-14. And the number of new returns, number of the new assessees which have been added during this year is around a crore. The exact figure is 99.5 lakh at the provisional, but it is something around a crore, which is a very good achievement of the department and, and the government's emphasis that the more person should come to the tax.
It's there in the press note. It's there in the press note. All the figures are there in the press note.
Total number there. 9.95 lakh crore. As against the BE of 9.8 lakh crore.
What was the RE?
10.05.
9.8 means 9.08. BE was 9.8 lakh crore. We have crossed that BE.
9.80 lakh.
Yeah. And we have crossed the BE. It is 9.95 lakh crore. Thank you.
Okay. One or two questions. Quick questions, yeah, please.
Sir, is there any review on the excise duty on petrol?
Not as of now. Whenever we review, we'll let you know.
Sir, but just to add to her question, it's persistently above 71, 72 levels.
That's a demand. That's a demand. But we'll let you know if we review. Right? Okay.
During trial period, about 6, 7 lakhs even bills were being generated. Now it's less than 3 lakhs. So what is the difference?
Not less than 3 lakhs. Where is it less than 3? That is only up to 3 o'clock. Na? The peak hour is only toward the evening. Most of the EVA bills are generated toward the evening only. So we'll have to see the entire day. But yes, it will take some time for people to warm up also. People will take some time. Over a period, it will have a gradient which is steep, you know. Abito, people are warming up still.
That was including interest rates.
Sorry?
That was including interest.
That was including intrastate also. Now intrastate is not there. It's only interstate. That was Karnataka intrastate also, you know. So
GST ke the total jitne registered hain usse kitne percent ki apeksha hai ki aap EV bill ke the registered ho jaye.
Nahi, aisa hai ki every registered person is not dispatching goods interstate. So only when they have to dispatch some goods interstate, they'll have to register. So I don't know. It is anybody's guess as to how many people are actually dispatching goods, you know. And plus, it is possible that the registered taxpayer may also get an e-way bill, or transporter can also do it, and even the receiver can do it. So in case of big companies, sometimes the receiver only issues the e-way bill, you know.
Sir, just one minute on GST, sir. So, going forward, we started FY19, sir. So how do you expect the revenue trend on GST to, I mean, you have already indicated it seems to be picking up.
It will pick up further as we have more compliance requirements coming into being, particularly the EVA bill. It should pick up even more. And also the various authorities are now getting a grip on who all are filing, who are not paying taxes, and things like that. So we'll be able to discover more of people who are actually collecting GST and not paying to the government. And recently our DG GST Investigation Cell Government has detected some 200 crore of such fraud taking place in which they have collected the GST and not paid. They've actually found some cases like that.
Sir, anti-profiteering, may abhi tak kitne complaint aaye, usme kya action abhi tak
liya gaya? I may not have the latest figure today because that was not the subject for discussion, but around 200 complaints are under, around 200. They are under. Only for few it has been completed because there is a minimum period of 3 months which is required. So,
sir, do you think the revised estimate for the direct tax collection was a little too aggressive, sir? And my second question to you is a lot of questions are being raised as far as the ICICI and the conflict of interest case is concerned. Has the government taken any cognizance of that?
I have nothing to say about it. It's an issue which you've been reading in the newspaper. I don't want to comment on it now. As far as direct tax, you are saying the revised estimate of the current year was aggressive.
Was it too aggressive?
No, we should always try to be more aggressive when it comes to targets, you know. So, but I hope ki this 9.95 will reach up to more than a 10 lakh crore. I mean, at least next 3-4 days, we will get adjustment of 5,000 crore. Itna to hoi jayega. So, it will be a landmark if we achieve 10 lakh figure in the current year.
Probably you're most confident on, which makes you
No, actually the figure of March revenue not coming to central government was factored at the time of RE. So we had reduced our RE figure accordingly, you know. So that was already taken care of. No, it is basically 25,000 crore to humne inka target bada diya tha, direct tax ka, compared to that shortfall. That is one. And secondly, some bit of more off budget funding of certain projects was also the way to do it.
So
not any major cut, unless it happens naturally, you know. If some department cannot spend it by 31st of March, that will remain as a less expenditure, you know. If some department cannot, in spite of giving them the money, if they are not able to spend it, then that becomes a natural saving. So that kind of natural saving may be there, but not otherwise.
So how much was the natural saving?
We have yet to calculate, right? Because only when the final expenditure figures come, which will come in the next few days, 10 din ke andar thoda pata chalega, then we can check with expenditure secretary and
sir,
okay.
Is there any proposal? Is there any proposal in the government consideration to shift from export subsidies to product subsidies, as the US has taken India to the WTO over this issue, that India is paying $7 billion worth annual export subsidies, which are violation of the WTO?
It's a subject relating to Commerce Ministry. I don't think I have the domain knowledge to answer this question. You may like to ask it to Commerce Ministry. Okay. Any other question?
So what was the collection for IT last year, sir?
For income tax?
Yeah.
Last year? He has given a 17% so growth rate, so you can calculate, you know.
Yes.
Okay. Broadly, yes, 98% of that, you know, we already achieved. Yeah.
Sir,
नहीं ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. लोगों को थोड़ा टाइम तो लगेगा एडजस्ट होने में, बट ओवर ए पीरियड द अथॉरिटीज विल स्टार्ट चेकिंग द ट्रक्स. दे विल हैव टू. Because if people are not carrying e-way bill, then it's not fair. In fact, we have been getting consistent demand from honest tax-paying class that please bring in e-way bill. Otherwise, there is a wholesale transfer of goods which is not bill paid, and that is why there is a lot of evasion taking place, and they are at disadvantage compared to those people who are evading the tax. So e-way bill is a system which has been demanded by honest tax-paying class. And we do hope that others will also fall in line and they will generate e-way bill to do this. If they don't do it, then there is a penalty provision for that.
So when do you plan to interstate pending?
We'll announce it after a week, you know. After a week of smooth rollout, we'll announce the first set of states where interstate will come from 15th of April. They'll come from 15th of April. Then 1 week after that, another group of states, like that gradual introduction of interstate GST. E-way bill. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, important comments coming in from the Revenue Secretary. The March end GST collection stand at 90,000 crore rupees. So far, the figure that has been noted for e-way bills stands at 2.89 till 4 p.m. and that was 2.59 till yesterday. We will get you more details and take this discussion forward with Shireen Bhan and our special panel of guests. But that will happen only after this very, very short break. Thank you for watching this special broadcast. GST Centimeter is up next.